Yo, what's good? It's your boy St. Joe, soundsofgear.com. Today, checking out the Pro 2 synth from Wave Alchemy. You may be used to them for their drums and loops and different stuff like that, sound effects, but they actually made a Contact synth. You need the full version of Contact to play this. It's based on the Sequential Circuits Pro 1. I've never played a Pro 1. I'm not going to be comparing it to a Pro 1. Basically, what I want to know is, does it capture the sound of an analog synth? Is it easy to tweak? Does it sound good? Is it easy to tweak? Is it fun to play with? Does it have a good interface? Does it sound good? So, you know, that's what we're going to be looking at. I think the conversion, it comes out to around $63, so not a bad deal. 30 is like 3.9 gigabytes, so we're going to go through. I got it pulled up in Contact 5, and we're just going to listen to it. You can see the Pro 2 presets here. Those are the ones that are made from the raw oscillators. And then the Pro 1 are based on the actual Pro 1 presets. Then there's the tune and detune. So let's just go through them and listen what they sound like. So there's the interface. Really nice interface. Really well laid out. You got your amp. You got your filter. There's your modulation area, basically your LFO. And then here's the raw oscillator section, which you got two oscillators that you can choose from. Stack them, you know, filter them, add those some sub oscillators, some white, pink noise, stuff like that. There's a nice little sequencer in there, 16 steps, pretty cool. Then you got some nice effects, so everything's really laid out well. And then of course over here you got the controls for number of voices, the detune amount, the monophonic, how it responds to the last note, first note, note priority, all that stuff, portamento, you know, your general stuff. So let's just listen to it. Definitely got a nice fat sound to it. If you want to turn the sequencer on, you got to use C8 and B7. C8 turns it on, and B7 turns it off. Adjust the length. You get the idea there. You can adjust the resonance and cutoff for each step, adjust the notes, all that stuff. So let's go back and check out some more. Definitely get some nice deep sounds out of it. So it's definitely got an analog sound to it. You can adjust the drift amount. And then this right here, if you turn this on, then your filter and amp section will match the link on each page. So if you make a adjustment here, then it'll be copied over here. If you make the adjustment over here, it'll be copied to the other one. If you can hear how deep that is, if you got your headphones on or you're listening in, if you're watching the HD version, but it's really thick sound. You can see there's a lot of presets in there. Let's see, maybe get a couple more and then go to some of the other ones. See what that sounds like. Different effects and stuff. Alright, let's check out some of the Pro 2 presets. See what those sound like. So these are made strictly with the raw oscillators. You can go in and change those. Modulation working, and you turn that on here, how much it works, and then you go over here to adjust it. Really good sound, man. Really, really good sound. That sound, that bass right there, crazy. Really deep, really nice. You can see the different waveforms they got in there. I like this chord preset. Some really, really nice presets. So you can definitely get the idea that it's got that thick. It does have an analog sound to it. They captured it really well. And they're sampling and then programming. Let's check out a couple of the multis. So they really put a lot of work into this, man. I'm impressed. I didn't know what to expect, but first thing I noticed, of course, is the interface is awesome. Love the interface. Really, really nice. But it's easy to use. It's functional. One thing that I really would have loved is if I could click on this and get a pop-out menu, because it's kind of, you know, going through there, having to hold it and go through the waves is a little, you know, it could be a little tedious, But you know, if you could just click it and get the waves that you want and choose them that way, I think that would really take it to the next level. Same with this one over here. But other than that, it's really cool, really, really fun to play. Does have an analog sound to it, definitely, which is what I was looking for. Like I said, does it sound like a Pro One? I don't know. I never had a Pro One, never played a Pro One, so you know, I'll leave that up to somebody else. But does it sound good? Yes. Does it sound analog? Definitely. The layout of it is great. It makes sense. It's fun to use, fun to look at. I have to have a synth that looks good to me. You know, some people say it doesn't matter, but to me, I like an interface that looks good. It makes me want to get in there and tweak it and play it and do a lot of stuff. So anyway, 4.5 out of 5, it's your boy St. Joe, SoundsOfGear.com, Wave Alchemy Pro 2 Synth, 4.5 out of 5 subs. Let me know what you think. Peace.